In this episode, we are going to one of the probably most famous locations in Denmark when it comes to landscape photography on the social medias. Rubjerg Knude Lighthouse is located in the northern part of Denmark, north of the town Lykken. When you have passed Lykken, you will hit the small town Rubjerg Gølstrup after 6 kilometers. When you reach that town, turn left on the first road and stay on that for another 6 kilometers. On your way, you will pass the exhibition of the lighthouse. Unless you want to visit that exhibition, just continue straight until you reach the parking lot. When you reach the parking lot, there's a 1 kilometer easy walk on a path of sand to reach the lighthouse. Rubjerg Knude Lighthouse is a very unique location. Where else in the world do you find a lighthouse which is being swallowed by a dune? The lighthouse is located between two ridges in the dune, which gives some really great vantage points. The biggest challenge photographing at this location is actually the wind, which hurls a lot of sand and dust around. Sadly, the wind also screwed up the sound on almost all my video. Luckily, the light were really beautiful, and after battling a bit with finding a proper composition where the human footprint in the wet sand weren't too distracting, I could set up the camera and capture the sunset. My main goal for the evening and night was to photograph the Milky Way, which at this time of year lines up with the lighthouse. While waiting for the moon to set and the Milky Way to become visible, I played around with some long exposures. I was really lucky to have the clouds coming towards me, which made for some cloud streaks I could line up with the lighthouse. Along with the leading lines from the path, the upper part of the dune and the horizon, all these elements forces the eye of the viewer towards the lighthouse. Just before the moon set, when the stars had already come forth, an absolutely stunning yet invisible phenomenon unfolded in front of me. I caught with my camera what my eyes couldn't see. I tried lining up the moon and the lighthouse, which created this natural glow of light around the lighthouse, which in combination with the backlit cloud streaks from the long exposure just made this rough Nordic yet very ethereal scene. As I talk about in my video from Death Valley, you have to be careful when you're changing lenses in sandy and windy environments. If you want to get a few tips and tricks on that, you can check out my video from Death Valley. And also remember headlamp if you're going to do night photography here. The way back to the car can be a bit tricky. When you're doing night photography, there's a lot of factors you need to balance out. I always start with the 500 rules, which states that you take 500 and divide it by your focal length. Then you will have the time you can exposure without getting star trails. As a rule of thumb, you always want to have as an open aperture as possible, which in my case is 1.4 since I'm using the Sigma 20mm 1.4. And another rule of thumb is of course to have as low ISO as possible. Depending on your scene and the technique you choose to use, you can stack multiple pictures in Photoshop to reduce noise. Sadly, I couldn't do that with this scene because I kept having clouds rolling in, which differed the scene so much that stacking them is next to nearly impossible. Consider the hard conditions, I am very pleased with the result in the end. Thanks so much for watching, I hope you enjoyed this first video from Denmark. As always, I would appreciate a like and a comment, and I would like to know if you find this place fascinating. Is this a place you would go and photograph if you could? And remember to hit that little bell icon next to the subscription button, then you will get a notification via Google each time I upload a new video. The next video is also from Denmark. We are going a bit down the coast to a place called Slettestrand.